of new season. Here we go. Right hand rod is, let's see what I can, about there on standard bottom bait. Middle rod is on a chod, and that is about there. The left hand rod is just to the left of me, probably 10-12 yards. That is on a snowman rig with a homemade kicker. Start of a new season. Well, I've had a run, 10:30 last night, and I nearly killed myself getting out my bivvy. Forgotten what it's like to get a run because I haven't been out. Hit into it, nothing there. So either could have been a serious liner or a trailer probably, but it could have been a fish. There's only one other lad here on the lake. He was just starting as I got here, so I don't think he's had a fish. I think I'd have heard it. He's not that far away from me. Show you me bait. These are my hook baits. As you can see, they are pretty soft. I've also got some homemade pop-ups. Get them. That's my pop-ups. And I have some, these are my feed boilies. These are a little bit harder, but a little bit more crumblier, so they do break down quite quick in the water. I also have a homemade paste. You can see that. It's a vanilla flavour, it's quite sweet. I am on a new water, so I don't know what's what, so I'm just trying different things, see how it goes. The anticipation of getting your first fish of the season is quite high. Has been a few fish out already this year. The last time I posted, there was two fish had been out, and I think it was a small double. I think it was a 19 or a 20 or something like that. Tell you what, there's any masses of them birds. Oh, I've had a roach top in front of me. There's absolutely loads of them. Hence why I'm not chucking out all of them. Well, just sat out for 10 minutes and it's absolutely freezing. Yeah, me, some heat. Oh, come on, give me a bite. Often while you're sat here on your own, you get a chance to reflect things that are happening and things are changing all the time. Change is good. Looking forward to this season, two new waters, QE2, Brasside. Yeah, well, some things never change. First breakfast, getting cooked. What I find over the years is if you don't take decent food with you, you will soon get tired and want to pack up and go home. Get disheartened a lot easier. Keep your blood sugars up and you'll be fine. Some beans or tomatoes, an egg, some toast, well away. Have it. Have it. Still on first breakfast, cooking me eggs. First breakfast, yummy. Hey, well, didn't take long, 10 minutes. Cook myself a fry up. Let's have it. Nice, what I've done, guys, I put a bit of hemp and ali crush, a tiny bit of water, some of my homemade goo. I'll put a bit more in so you can see. Make sure that's well mixed in. My homemade version of goo is morning syrup. It's a coffee syrup, vanilla flavour. Then there is glycerin, which is mega sweet, and gin. Now, any spirits will do, whatever your flavour is. Suggestions of vodka, that's a good suggestion. And what's that other one? Aniseed one. Fennel. As you can see that. And then this is hemp oil. Squirt of that. Now, hemp oil, get it from Tesco's. It's about £6. I think it's 500 mils, so it's probably the cheapest you're going to get. And it is decent, and you can use it all year round. So give it a good mix in. What I'll do with that is I will make little sausages out of it. I'll show you my rig I'll be using. Right. That is a homemade vanilla boilie. I've just trimmed the edges off a bit with a solar fake pink boilie. Hook is an avid, is it a curved shank? and then on a swivel, and it'll just go straight in the end of my rig. Right. Time to make the sausage up. I've already made one up and put it in the water and see how long it takes. I will show that on the video. Once you've tied one knot in it, get another one in and that'll do you for the next time. Right, so this is... And there we have one little mesh sausage. I have put sticky baits, you can see that, micro pellets and 4mm pellets in there. There is bloodworm and there's vortex. So, all I'll do with that now, normally I would hook that in the knot, because the water is still cold. I'm just gonna hook it twice just below the knot. If that can swing all the way around, which it can't, if it swung all the way around I'd have taped the boilie to the take the boiler to the sausage. And that's my rig. It's about 5 inches. The braid I'm using is Gardner Catfish Snag Leader. As you can see, it is a very thin braid. This is a 35 pound, but it's about the thickness of 15 pound of a normal braid, and it has like a waxy coating. But what you can do, if you want to use pop-ups and that, you can just trim that waxy bit off there and it'll give you that bit more movement. But I don't think I need it. Anyway, that's me rig. Well, that's me sausage just made up. A little PVA sausages, oh, where are we? There we are. There's what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's about 10 there. The PVA I'm using is the Castaway stuff. That's the one I'm using at the moment. It does take a couple of minutes to break down in the water. I will show you the video. Bear in mind that the water is still cold, so that's what I'll be chucking out. Bit awkward trying to film it like this, but there you go. Right, one little tip when making them sausages: old string and needle. It's only a cheap one. What I've done, I've took the handle off. Well, actually the handle fell off. So now it gives me a nice thin sharp end to put on the sausage, connect that to your hook link with the hook on it, and pull it all the way through like so. So a handy little tool out of nothing. Well, the time is 2 minutes to one. I've had another liner. Apart from that, that's it. Recasted out, same spots. I'm going to give it till tonight and I'm going to try somewhere else. Same peg, just different spots. Obviously, I need to find out as much as I can about the place. And the only way I'm going to do that is by chucking out a little bit more often. Well, tonight I've got curry for my tea. Seems a popular place, this lake. Right, I've just seen a fish in that corner. Where are we? In that corner. 3 foot arms jump out. I thought it was a duck at first. And boom, out again, again and again and again. Well, this is the peg I seen that fish jump out, somewhere around here. Well, here we go, going towards Lake 2. More of a match type lake, but it would make a canny little carp lake like. How far it is to the next one. See, all the pegs are well maintained. Ideal pool venue. Dig two again, the other side. That is Lake 4. pig. Yeah, that's the other biggest lake. Well, I'm here and I'm learning. What I found out is there's a load of dead weed just on the left hand side of me, and it goes down and up again onto a bar. When I chuck the lead out and bring it back, it's duh, duh, so you know it's dead weed. But no doubt come the summer, you're not going to be able to drag it through that too easy. But after seeing that fish in that far corner, I'm thinking, shall I move? I don't know. See, it's not even back up on the back of the wind, where the water might be warmer. I was told it is deep over that side, over the right hand side. But it is only my first trip, so I don't know. Sun's out now. That wind is cold. When the sun comes out, it is warm. As soon as you step foot in that wind, it ain't. Poof. Well, I just changed the middle rod, I took the chud off and put a multi-rig on. Let's see if that makes a difference. I've no signs on the middle and the right hand rod yet. But here's open. Chance with a bro. Now 4:30. But no more signs, nothing. There are a few more anglers here now, so what I have seen in here, there's a lot of spomming going on. The lads chucking big leads in, a lot bigger than you actually need, you know, trying to find either holes or plateaus. There's even a lad fishing off the top. Good luck to him. It's absolutely freezing out there. but it feels as if it's freezing. Might be just me. First coffee of the day. But I wish I had that run again I had last night. It's just not warm enough to sit out. So I think it'll be an early night tonight and up early in the morning. I'm happy. I think I'm fishing okay. I think where I'm fishing I think is fine. Have I put enough bait in? I don't know. I'm like on the edge. Do I put some in? Don't I put some in? Sometimes you don't know what to do. Still being cautious. I keep putting the little mesh bags of bait in. Just need a little bit of action now. When I do get home, I'll be planning another sesh pretty quick after getting home. So whether it's here or whether it's at QE2, I don't know. Well, a new day, a new dawn, no signs during the night, we'd have a bit of rain. The wind we've had, coming into the left hand corner, it's been quite cold. It seems to have switched a bit now, it's coming towards me and to the right of me. I don't know what direction that is. But it does feel a little bit warmer. Well, 8 o'clock on a Tuesday morning. Apart from that one run and a couple of liners when I first got here, no signs, nothing last night, not a bleep. The wind has switched slightly. It's coming towards me and to the right a bit. The back of the wind is now over on that far side. You can see that. Right over there. Really, I should have been on the back of the wind, I think, but I'm still hoping. I should have had one fish. Had a good kip last night. Should have been up more, I think. Cast around a bit more. But I'm going to put two rods to my left today. And that just have the one rod in front of me. So I do think I've got more chance of catching a fish either in this corner or on that bar on the left hand side. Probably 50 foot to my left hand side. There is a bar and you can see it on Google Maps. So I'm going to be fishing, I won't fish on top of it, I'm going to fish probably halfway up it. Or to the bottom of it maybe, I don't know yet. The sun is trying to get out. It does feel a couple of degrees warmer than it did yesterday, so that is a bonus. Well, let's have a look at the tackle I take with me. Right, first tackle box. It's a Witchwood tackle box. Right, inside. Just bought these. So, I have barbless avid hooks. And then we have the chud versions. And the wide gate versions. Right. Plenty of bass heads if I need them. I do make them myself. Right. What I was on about, what hooks I use. Right, be able to show you exactly what hooks I use. Right, authentic Czech nymph hooks. Right, these are a curve shank hook. They are very, very sharp. They're probably sharper than carp hooks. And the other ones I use are, I'll get them out. There you go. Big mouth nymph hooks. Now these hooks, I actually like using these on zigs. They are big and I have caught using them. You can see that it has an interned eye. There's only one downside to it, it has got the big barb on. but when I use them I do file it off. I use them hooks 99% of the time when I'm fishing. And then we have avid corn stops, they're all floating ones. I've got a little hook on them. Right. These are my swivels and clips and ring eye swivels. What else have we got in there? Quick link swivels. In there. No, really. Right. Fox weights. You have a little bit of rubber which slides in between the gap, which holds it on your line. Ideal for pop-ups, stuff like that. And then we have all the bits of rubber like sleeves and leg clips, stuff like that. Big putty. Bait screws. Then we have fake baits. Looks like a candy shop. We have avid ones in there. You name it, it's every make. And then we've got all like tubings and leg core, bait floss, super floss, power gum. Right, mishmash of gear in here. That's where I keep my long shank hooks. I use solo long shanks. As you can see, yeah, I'm a big fan of them. Fox hook, ESP hooks, Nash hooks. Tubing. Shrink tubing, crimps, pliers. Everything I would ever need, but probably for any rig. Right, so let me grab a bait toolkit. See what we've got in here. Hook sharpener. Absolutely fantastic bit of kit. It's £2 out of Lidl. has got a groove in it, so you can slide your hook up and down it. Well, I have moved my rods now. I have now two to the left of me. I'm slack lining on both of them, and my right hand one is straight out in front of me, about there. See, the sun is starting to come out. Another angle has come. Well, 10:30, day two. The wind's probably coming straight in at me now, if not a little bit to the right. I've had a little bit of rain again. It is very overcast, but that sun's trying to come out. I hope it does, just give me a bit of warmth. It has been quite a cold session. I'm spending most of my time like looking out on the water to see if I can see any signs of fish, any at all, even small fish. And to be fair, I haven't seen much. That bottom left hand corner yesterday, a fish jumped out 3-4 times. I was thinking of moving, but then I thought, well, it's information for the next time I come. I don't want to be chasing fish today. So what I have done to add that little bit more to my baits, I don't know whether you've heard of a burger rig. It's where you put like small, yeah, you can see them, small marshmallows in between a cup boilie. Just gives it that little bit of extra sugar and whatever else marshmallows have in. There you go, look at that. anything I can do that's a little bit different to what they used to, they may not think it's a hazard that's got a hook behind it. I will try anything at least once. Well, started lashing down, so calved up. So I think it'll be another movie, and see what happens. Well, traps are set again, took a walk around, videoed a little bit on a couple of the other little lakes. I've now got two on the bar to my left and one in front of me. I've got one on a homemade vanilla, and the other is on a tutti frutti pop-up with an avid corn stop, floating corn stop on it. So I have got one on the bottom and one on a pop-up. One in front of me is on a multi-rig, and that is a homemade cell type pop-up. Wind's got back up again, it has been raining.